Okay, today we're going to talk about Mercedes GLK 2013 and later, specifically 250, so the diesel trailer hitch. So I just installed my hitch the other day. It's a CURT 13155, and it's the only one that'll fit the diesel. It will not fit the non-diesel, and the non-diesel one will not fit the diesel because of this thing, this big DEF tank. A guy did a really, really good video on putting it in the diesel, the exact same hitch. So I'm going to link in the description to his video so you can watch that video if you need help or reference with that. It's not an easy job. Excuse me, bit of a cold. It's about a 2-hour job. But the monkey in the room is the, or elephant in the room, is the wiring. What the hell do you do with the wiring? Especially if you've got the LED taillight package, which combines... This is the turn signal. It is also the brake light. So it's a dual purpose light. And because it's LED, it's low voltage. So the low draw, if you try and wire it regularly, you can't. There's two circuits going to the power circuits going into here at all times. Anyway, I'll tell you the colors you need and what you need to do this. It's not as hard as people are going to tell you to tell you. It's not dangerous. It's not hard. If you've got, this is again, the GLK 250 diesel. So this is what you need. The CURT 56496. This is a powered circuit protected trailer connector. And what this is, it has to take its own power. So it gets power. It's not using power from your bulbs. Or your lights, your turn signals, your tail lights, whatever. It is taking a signal from them and then using the power to send the power out to your trailer connector down here. So I'll quickly go through this. I haven't cleaned this up yet, so you can see what it looks like. I haven't wrapped all the wires and stuff like that and run them properly because I want you to be able to see what's what. So this connector, I just bolted it here, mounted it onto the, I guess this is the DEF heater or the DEF pump, one of the two, it's something in there. So I've used this as the mounting point. There's a little screw mounting point on this, and this wire was attached to it with a little bracket. I'll be tying this up later on so it doesn't flop around. This is the ground wire that comes with the kit. It's white. The red wire is supposed to be brakes. This is the important part. The red wire is supposed to be the brake signal wire, but you are not going to be using the brake signal. You are going to be taking that and also grounding it to your ground. So brake and the ground, the red and the white, will ground to this ground post here, or whatever ground you want to use. You can do it inside one of the sides, whichever. Yellow is left, and that will go to pink, the pink wire going into your taillight connector. Brown is taillights. That will go into a gray and lavender. There's a gray and lavender and a gray and blue. Gray and lavender is the taillight. That will hook up to your brown. Your green will go to the other side and hook up into the blue that goes into this wiring harness, the blue. And I've used wire splices on this. I've used them a million times before. As long as you use them properly, you're fine. And then finally, the black is power. Now you want something when the ignition is, excuse me, ignition power. So I took this A fuse in the diesel. It's a 20 amp, and I just put a fuse tap in there, which is a tap that pops out and you add a fuse to it. So the yellow is the original 20 amp fuse. The blue is the fuse that's coming out and powering my CURT hitch. So let's recap. Black is power. I'm drawing power from this fuse, which is ignition on fuse. So it's only works with the ignition. Black, ignition. White is regular ground. It comes with a little ground stud on it, a little round ring terminal. Red, which is supposed to be brakes, supposed to be the brake feed. that will get a little ring terminal and also be grounded. Everything else is by the colors is normal. Tail light, brown. Right turn, green. Left turn, yellow. All works perfectly. I've checked it. It works fine. There is no light warnings on the dash, no nothing. And I'm just going to clean up this wiring, and I'll put all the colors in the description as well. The original colors from your coming out of your tail lights. I'll put those in there, and yeah, and the link to the guy's description. Excuse me, God, my voice. To installing the trailer hitch, which is a really, really good. I couldn't do a better video than he did, so why did I bother? Why bother? Anyway, I'm gonna clean this all up, and I'll show you what it looks like in a minute. Okay, and there's the wiring mostly tidied up. It's a little bit of a jumble, but whatever. This is the one last thing. There's a little bung plug here at the back behind. I don't know what this is. I wish I knew more of the stuff that was on this diesel. I haven't just gone through it. I don't know what everything is, but anyway, there's a little body plug there that you can pull out, and it goes straight down, and that would fit the wire out to the trailer hitch. Just cut a slit in it, poke the wire through, and silicone it up. Once you're done, you've got your length, the proper length done. I just haven't done that wiring yet. I haven't tied that up to the wiring sheath yet. And that's about it. Again, any questions, feel free to ask. Like, comment, subscribe. Thanks for watching. Quick revision. Ran the wiring to go back to the hitch underneath this plate here. There's plenty of room for it. I just made sure to insulate. I wrapped it in Gorilla tape just to keep it insulated from the metal. It's not really sharp or anything, but just in case. Wrapped it underneath this metal bracket, because there needs to be space here for that little the lid of the cover has this very special groove built into it that goes right alongside this wiring harness and goes in there. So I had the wiring up there. I just had to move that, and the wire that goes to the side that used to be posted to here, I just put it up, moved it up over top, and that was it. Everything else is cool and out of the way. Thanks for watching.